Thanks for joining us on the CBN News Channel. I'm Ephraim Graham.
And I'm Heather Sells. The president is calling all Senate Democrats to the White House today. The mission, cut a deal on health care reform. With Republicans united in opposition, the Democrats need all 60 votes from their caucus. But late Monday, independent Joe Lieberman said he could not support the bill because of Medicare expansion.
I've been focused on trying to get it back to its strong core and take off some of the stuff that runs the risk of creating federal debt.
But Lieberman's not the only senator that the Senate leadership is worried about. Senators Bob Casey and Ben Nelson want stricter limits on abortion. And Senator Byron Dorgan wants to allow cheaper prescription drugs from Canada, a move opposed by the pharmaceutical companies and the White House. Publicly, Senate Democrats are downplaying their differences.
Whatever differences exist within the United States Senate, those differences will pale by comparison to the differences we can make with the American public with the passage of major health care reform.
And leadership is ever mindful that without the magic 60 votes to ward off a Republican filibuster, their bill is doomed.
I'd like to bring this body to a screeching halt.
The fact that with, you know, a 60-40 advantage in the Senate, you're looking to Republicans either to blame or to provide you with the vote you need, tells me that there's something desperately wrong with the bill when you can't get your own people on board.
A top administration economic advisor admitted Monday that the Democratic-backed health care plan would raise spending in the short run.
President Obama met with top banking officials to pressure them to do more to revive the struggling economy. He says they need to rework mortgages and offer new loans to small businesses. Publisher and financial expert Steve Forbes tells CBN News the ongoing push for more government control will have consequences.
We know what works, and clearly free people and free markets work, not more government takeover. What we see in Washington today is really a form of neo-socialism. They're trying to take over the banks, the auto industry, insurance companies, even banks that don't owe money to the government. They want to now tell them the Federal Reserve wants to tell them what they can pay people. That's not the way to a true lasting prosperity.
Forbes also says that voters are getting tired of government spending and they will feel the effects come election 2010.
The Washington, D.C. City Council is voting on a measure to legalize gay marriage today. Hundreds of gay marriage supporters rallied in support of the measure last night. The bill overwhelmingly passed an earlier vote, and the mayor has pledged to sign it if it makes it past the final hurdle. The city council refused to let D.C. residents vote on the issue. Opponents will continue lobbying members of the U.S. Congress to overturn the bill. Congress has final authority over the district's affairs.
British lawmakers are considering a measure that would force homeschoolers to register with the government. And that has some homeschool groups concerned. The U.S.-based Homeschool Legal Defense Association says the bill gives local officials power to decide if families can homeschool. The bill would also require criminal background checks of parents. HSLDA's Director of International Relations says if this bill were to pass, it would be the most restrictive and overbearing homeschooling law in the English-speaking world. In the U.S., most states simply require notification and do not tell families if they can or cannot homeschool. British Prime Minister Gordon Brown is supporting the proposal.
The Obama administration is taking a major step towards closing the Guantanamo Bay prison. Today, the White House is announcing the federal government will assume control of the Thompson Correctional Center in Thompson, Illinois. And then move some of the inmates from Cuba to that maximum security prison. It's about 150 miles west of Chicago. The move could bring jobs to the small, struggling town, but residents aren't sure they want it.
I really have mixed feelings about it. Generally, I think that economically, I think the prospects are wonderful. My limiting factor again is, and I don't think you can reduce all of life to an economic decision. I think you have to weigh carefully these other possibilities. And really all I'm asking is that we do dialogue about the reality of those possibilities.
The prison will also house other federal inmates.
New top secret intelligence documents show Iran is working on a key final component of a nuclear bomb. The London Sunday Times reports the papers document Iran's most sensitive military nuclear project. It outlines a 4-year plan to test a trigger device that can only be used in a nuclear weapon. The documents are from early 2007. That is a full 4 years after Iran had supposedly suspended its weapons program.
In communist-run Vietnam, a historic event happened over the weekend when tens of thousands of Christians worshipped publicly. This after many years of persecution and hardships. Here's our report from Ho Chi Minh City.
This is a sight that many here thought they'd never see. The gospel openly proclaimed in communist Vietnam. For decades, most of Vietnam's Christians have been forced to worship in secret. But on this night, the government gave permission for house churches to hold an outdoor evangelistic service. And more than 35,000 people showed up. It's a testimony to the faith and perseverance of the country's church leaders.
As Americans, we take these kinds of things for granted. The opportunity to gather and assemble and to worship and celebrate Christmas. But in Vietnam, the government has not allowed this, and there has not been something like this for 35 years.
Most Vietnamese have never heard the gospel message, so when the pastor gave the altar call, some 8,000 people responded. CBN Asia correspondent Lucille Talusan was there.
Thousands of people came forward to surrender their lives to Jesus Christ. Actually, the stage was not able to hold all the people. That's why most of the people have come here up front on the ground.
I feel very happy because I can become a Christian. I cannot describe my feeling now. Really very happy, I can cry.
Overwhelmed by the success of the event, organizers fell to their knees in thanks. It would be premature to say that religious freedom has come to Vietnam. In fact, police stopped several buses carrying Christians from outlying provinces to keep them from attending the event. Nevertheless, these leaders are encouraged to press on until the gospel message is heard throughout their country.
God is working marvelously in ways we cannot imagine. We have experienced many great things that God is doing in this country, and so we believe that there will be more greater things to come.
We dream that in every village in Vietnam, we will have the big crusade so that thousands, millions of Vietnamese can come to the Lord.
George Thomas, CBN News.
Israel's chief rabbi made a rare visit to a Palestinian village to condemn what appears to be a Jewish attack on a mosque. Vandals torched the mosque Friday, burning books and prayer rugs. John Waghi explains how this could raise already high tensions in the West Bank.
On a rare visit to the northern West Bank, Israel's chief rabbi visited the mosque and condemned the attack, which many believe was carried out by Jewish settlers.
71 years ago, the Nazis burned hundreds of synagogues, and we are until today with the same feeling about the trauma that the Jewish nation has. Therefore, I came to say to our neighbors, the Muslims, that we are against burning any holy place.
The mosque burning was just one incident that has stoked tension in recent days. Jewish West Bank residents are angry about the government's decision to freeze all building in Judea and Samaria for 10 months. That could be the motive for Friday's incident. Meanwhile, some Palestinian leaders have encouraged violence to support President Mahmoud Abbas's decision to reject peace talks with Israel. In the past week, security forces have caught several Palestinians trying to smuggle knives or explosives through checkpoints. Before the rabbi's visit, Arab youths threw stones at Israeli soldiers. Palestinian leaders want Israeli security to crack down on settlers. That increases the urgency for the Netanyahu government to solve the mosque burning case. John Waghi, CBN News.
Back here in the U.S., the search continues for the climbers missing on Oregon's Mount Hood. Saturday, researchers found the body of 26-year-old Luke Goldberg. 24-year-old Anthony Vietti and 29-year-old Katie Nolan are still missing. They are Christians who have served around the world as missionaries.
They all three loved hiking and they all three loved Jesus.
Yesterday morning, early, as I was praying, I felt God said, like a mustard seed. That's all the faith you have to have. If you have the faith like a mustard seed, you can say to this mountain, mountain, be moved, and it will be done.
These three young people were vibrant Christian young men and a young woman. They had dedicated their lives to serving and giving to others. And their families are very, very proud of them.
See, these kids loved climbing, all three of them. They climbed together often. They climbed hard mountains together before, and they did it successfully and well, and they were careful climbers.
We just want to make sure that you know that we have God's peace in our hearts, and we know all three love Jesus, and we are confident in that, and that's our rock.
Pray for our climbers. These are two young people who are already making a difference in the world. These are two passionate and two of the people with the most integrity that I've ever seen in a young person. Thank you for listening, but most of all, thank you for praying for us.
Bad weather and risk of avalanches have been hampering rescue attempts.
Coming up, software that keeps teens from texting and driving.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart.
These are the most powerful songs of our time.
Now is the time to worship.
And now, for the first time, the biggest praise and worship songs are together.
How great.
Presenting Songs for Worship 50. 50 songs in one specially priced collection.
Holy is the Lord, God Almighty. The earth is filled.
You'll hear 50 beautiful songs of hope.
I'm coming back to the heart of worship. And it's
50 powerful songs of faith. Get Songs for Worship 50 on three CDs for only
$24.99.
But wait, order in the next 10 minutes with your credit card and we'll take $15 off. That's right. You get 50 praise and worship songs for just
$9.99.
Then preview other great praise and worship collections. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
So call now and get Songs for Worship 50. 50 beautiful songs on three CDs for just $9.99.
Call 1-800-435-3414 to order Songs for Worship 50 on three CDs for $9.99 plus shipping and handling when you use your credit card. Call now or order online at timelife.com/songsforworship50.
Using the internet can help keep your brain young. That is according to a study by the University of California. Researchers found that adults between 55 and 78 who began surfing the web improved their brain function after only a few days. They say using the internet is interactive, and that stimulates more activity in the part of the brain that makes decisions. Doctors say engaging in cognitive activities might be a way to protect against dementia.
North Carolina is the latest state to make it illegal to text and drive. Laws now ban the practice in more than 14 states and the District of Columbia. But changing the law doesn't always change behavior, especially among young drivers. And that's where technology comes in. Today's teens text more than they talk.
13,000 a month.
I probably have like 200 already today.
Like at least 300 or 200, yeah.
A day.
Like a day.
It's an addictive pastime that can get out of control and drive parents crazy.
When I bought my kids a cell phone, I didn't realize that texting was going to be such a huge ordeal. They text in the morning. They text after school, they text in the evening.
And it's been difficult for Chris Mayer to control until now. The father of two helped to develop text safety. software that arms parents with power to limit exactly when teens can text, and more importantly, when they can't.
As a dad, I knew that about 33% of the kids have accidents within the first 6 months of driving, and texting and driving is a huge problem.
Studies show at least 60% of young drivers are guilty of texting while driving. Text Safety aims to reduce that statistic. Once the software is downloaded to the phone, it detects when it's inside a vehicle traveling at least 10 miles an hour, and texting is not allowed.
Can't text, you can't chat, you can't do instant messenger, you can't do YouTube. It disengages anything that could distract the driver from driving.
And when it comes to distractions, safety experts say the dangers of texting behind the wheel rival even drinking and driving.
That combines the cognitive distraction of having a conversation with someone with the physical distraction of holding something and the visual distraction of actually looking at it. So I think even without studies, I think most of us would know that texting when you're driving is a dangerous thing to do. It puts yourself and other drivers at risk.
Text Safety puts control in parents' hands.
When I knew my little girl was going to be driving, I thought I've got to do something to disengage texting while driving.
And that isn't the only thing Mayer's product does. It's set to sound an alarm on the teen's phone and send a text alert to the parent when the vehicle is going more than 65 miles an hour.
My teenager was going to a soccer game and the bus driver was running late, was speeding over 65, going 70, 73 miles an hour, and I actually got an alert stating that my little girl was traveling in excess of 65.
And GPS showed him exactly where she was. It's added security for parents when their children are on the road, and it's just a computer click away. Chris Mayer has also helped to develop software that allows parents to set schedules on the phones when kids can and cannot text.
Up next, a look at the history of the modern charismatic movement and how it's influencing the church.
Israel, the land where God came to mankind. Imagine to be in the place where our Lord lived, to stand where he performed his miracles, to see where he taught the multitudes. The pages of the Bible come alive in the land filled with God's promises. Don't miss this experience of a lifetime. Visit Israel. You'll never be the same.
Call today.
Each week, thousands of concerned parents and grandparents start Globe Young American plans for their children and grandchildren. The Young American plan is a simple, affordable way to secure valuable life insurance protection. Starting a Young American plan today guarantees the future insurability of your loved ones. Once issued, the Young American plan can never be canceled. For just $1, you can start a Young American plan and feel safe knowing you've provided your child or grandchild with a lifetime of protection. The regular premium you establish now is guaranteed to never increase, and the Young American plan builds cash value that can be used in the future. Since 1964, millions of concerned parents and grandparents have started Globe Young American plans for their children and grandchildren. Call Globe today.
Call right now for complete information about the Globe Young American Plan. Call Globe today at 1-800-457-4154.
Israel, the land where God came to mankind. Imagine to be in the place where our Lord lived, to stand where he performed his miracles, to see where he taught the multitudes. The pages of the Bible come alive in the land filled with God's promises. Don't miss this experience of a lifetime. Visit Israel. You'll never be the same.
Call today.
The charismatic movement has had a huge influence on the shape of the church in today's world, but it hasn't really received much serious attention from journalists.
That is, until now. The journalist who's writing about it is Julia Dean of the Washington Times. Paul Strand recently spoke with her about her new book, Days of Fire and Glory, the rise and fall of a charismatic community.
Welcome to this edition of Quick Hits. I'm Paul Strand. Today we're talking with Julia Dean, the religion editor of the Washington Times. She's just written this exciting new book, Days of Fire and Glory. And Julia, we're standing here at Christ Church in Washington, D.C. What did this have to do with the charismatic renewal which you're writing about in this book?
Well, Christ Church was the site of Take and Give, which is called TAG, which was one of the biggest meetings in Washington, D.C. in the 1970s. 2,000 people packed the place on Tuesday nights. I was one of those people. I was in college at the time, and it was just amazing to be here and to see the worship, the prophecies. I mean, it was like the center in Washington.
You were part of a community in Houston that had a huge role in the charismatic movement, right?
Yes, I was in, well, I lived in actually a Christian community in Portland, Oregon, and then I moved to Houston, and when I was with the Houston Chronicle, I was a member of Church of the Redeemer. It was a major Episcopal church that was like one of the top centers of the renewal, along with a few other churches. They were the ones that helped the Catholics get into the charismatic movement.
Redeemer was an Episcopalian church. Is that how the Episcopalian denomination became involved in the charismatic movement?
Yes, there were several churches. Redeemer was one of the top ones. Its leader, Graham Polkinghame, got baptized in the Spirit in 1964 at the hands of David Wilkerson. He went back down to Houston. The whole church turned into a major renewal center. They were the ones that put together the Jesus movement, the people living in communities. They pioneered many things that the renewal became known for.
Now, you yourself belong to a charismatic community. Many Christians today are interested in the idea of Christian community, but are there dangers there?
Well, there were, because there was a lot of authoritarianism. That was what my master's degree was on, in fact. That was how authoritarianism tends to creep into the charismatic movement. It's not like anybody planned it, but because of people following the teachings of Watchman Nee and certain other people, in that things got rather oppressive very fast. It seemed like control entered the picture. And then things kind of started going downwards. And it was just that a lot of sexual sin happened. I don't know why the charismatics got so afflicted with it, but unfortunately, it's true.
So what brought Redeemer down specifically? I mean, that's a major part of your investigation for this book. What brought it down?
Well, a couple things. The sexual sin of its major leader, Graham Polkinghame, didn't help at all. He was a gay man, as it turned out. He was hitting on some of his counselees. And I think that was just... spiritually, that really affected his church, because a lot of stuff was happening in his church that we didn't understand why this went on. And then also, too, there was a lot of control, especially in the Catholic charismatic renewal. And there was the money part wasn't too bad, but in certain other parts of the charismatic Pentecostal movement, there was a real problem with people misusing funds. So it was like the sex, money, and power, that troika. Just people fell into just the stuff that you could have predicted would happen.
The charismatic renewal is going gangbusters many places overseas. Why do you think it's stalled here in America in so many places?
I think people haven't dealt with the root causes of the sin. Again, we have Ted Haggard, who just, 2 years ago, was another gay man who never told anybody what was going on. He was not accountable, which was the problem with Graham Polkinghame, who was also not accountable, even though he was in the Episcopal Church. So you've got all these root problems. I sometimes think God is withholding revival until they're dealt with.
Julia, how does your personal life fit into all this? I mean, why did you write the book, and how's it affected you?
Way back in the 1970s, I really thought Christian community was the future of Christianity. I lived in a community for 2 years in Portland, Oregon, and then when I happened to get a job with the Houston Chronicle, I was extremely interested in what was going on there. They had 400 people in community. They were like the top of the country. Everybody went to Houston to see how they did community, because it was a great way to minister to the poor. So I was a member of Redeemer, and then I went to Pittsburgh to get a master's degree, and that's where I met Graham Polkinghame, the man who this book is about, and who is the perfect example of how the renewal rose and how it fell, and as he did die in disgrace, unfortunately, in 1993.
Well, thank you, Julia. Fascinating interview. We've been speaking with Julia Dean, the religion editor at the Washington Times. She's just written Days of Fire and Glory, The Rise and Fall of a Charismatic Community. I'm Paul Strand. Thanks so much for joining us for this edition of Quick Hits. Please stay tuned to the news on the CBN News Channel.
When we come back, say cheese, an image of Santa like you've never seen before. We'll be right back.
Introducing Easy Combs, the easy new way to create dazzling new do's. Simply slide in one end, stretch it around your hair, and slide in on the other side for an updo that's brand new. Or fluff it out for a fountain effect. Look again. The bungee band stretch and release for a relaxed custom fit every time. Liven up a ponytail or create this amazing butterfly twist. It's great for short hair and ideal for the office. It's perfect for any formal occasion. Ouch, claw clips hurt, but Easy Combs are soft and comfortable, so easy to use, kids love them too. Now get Easy Combs in caramel bronze for only $10. Call now and get one in dazzling silver. As a special bonus, get our Bermuda black plus a styling DVD. Just pay separate shipping and handling. With a step-by-step DVD, Easy Combs are a cinch. You get caramel, silver, and black plus the style guide and DVD, a $60 value, all for only $10.
Call 1-800-520-1486. You'll get the bonus Easy Combs as advertised when you call 1-800-520-1486.
Love to shop for shoes, but there's no place to store them? You're always running out of room to store more. Introducing Shoes Under, the easy solution to organize and protect your shoes. The clear zipper cover locks out dust and moisture. Now you just slide and store. It's that easy. With two handles, you can easily store your shoes here, under there, almost everywhere, and turn an empty space into a super storage place. Other shoe organizers can cost a fortune, but through this exclusive television offer, you can get the 12-compartment Shoes Under for only $19.99. Call now and we'll cut that price in half. That's right, for only $10. And as a bonus, we'll double the offer and give you a second Shoes Under that's enough space for 48 shoes. Just pay separate shipping and handling. Call now and get two Shoes Under for only $10.
Call 1-800-943-1652. You'll get a second one free, so call 1-800-943-1652. That's 1-800-943-1652. Call now.
One donation this holiday season is receiving a lot of attention. In Denver, Colorado, two rare and valuable gold coins were given to the Salvation Army. The coins were found in the familiar red kettles, all part of the organization's annual fundraising efforts. One is a South African coin, and it's valued at $1,200 to $1,700. The charity's leaders say the gifts could not have come at a better time.
The requests that have come to us are up. We've had more people asking for help. So these gold coins will make a big difference, helping to pull us back up to the needed amounts to carry out this Christmas.
So far, no one knows who donated those coins.
And finally today, here's a creative take on Santa Claus in the famous cheese state of Wisconsin. Experts have carved a giant Santa out of Wisconsin cheddar. They used three 640-pound blocks of cheese to mold the perfect Santa. It was completed on Sunday, coming in around 66 inches tall and 28 inches wide. And I have to say, for my grew up in Illinois, I've always heard Wisconsinites complain about being called cheeseheads, but they bring it on themselves.
Yeah, they do indeed. They do indeed. That is going to do it for this hour of the CBN News Channel.
We hope you'll join us next time. Have a great day.
Daddy?
Yeah, buddy?
How many nickels are in a dollar?
There are 20 nickels in a dollar.
How do birds fly? Does milk really make my bones stronger?
Yeah.
Daddy, when we die, will we go to heaven?
Do you have the answer to life's biggest question? Call the 700 Club. We'll help you find answers to the important questions life brings your way.
Fresh, wholesome juice. There's nothing like it. But until now, you had to stress and strain and make a huge mess to get just a little bit of juice. But not anymore, thanks to the Jack LaLanne Power Juicer. You can drop in whole vegetables, whole fruits, apples, oranges, celery, cucumbers with no chopping, no slicing, no struggling. And thanks to the Power Juicer's revolutionary patented extraction technology, you can get up to 30% more juice than those other juicers. Doctors recommend we get 5 to 9 servings of fruits and vegetables every day. With the Power Juicer, you'll be drinking your recommended daily allowance in just seconds. And the pulp from the extra large pulp catcher can be used to make pasta sauces, healthy desserts, and much more. The Power Juicer is dishwasher safe, so cleanup's a breeze, and the powerful motor is guaranteed for life. Order the Jack LaLanne Power Juicer now for just 2 easy payments of $49.90. And as part of this special TV offer, we'll also send you this amazing recipe guide filled with over 60 of Jack's favorite recipes. Try the Jack LaLanne Power Juicer in your home risk-free for 30 days. If you're not completely satisfied, send it back for a full refund of the purchase price, no questions asked. Call now.